Hello students, now let's move towards our next chapter, that is fiber to fabric. In class 6, we have learned there are various processes are there through which we are converting that fiber into the fabric. So here, as we all know, the meaning of fiber is thread and the meaning of fabric is clothes. So how with the help of fiber we are converting into the clothes. So basically we know that there are two types of fibers are there, natural fiber and man-made fiber. Natural fiber, the fiber which we get from the nature, that means from the plants, from the animals, with the help of plants and animals. And the man-made fiber, that is synthetic one, that with the help of some chemical substance, with the help of machines, we made that fiber. So in the natural fiber, the fiber which we get from plants and the animals, that means from the nature we are getting that fiber. So from the plants we are getting cotton and jute, and from the animals wool and silk we get. Now in this chapter we are going to learn about that two fibers that we get from animals, that is wool and silk, that how we are getting the fiber wool and how we are getting the fiber silk from the animals. Here, wool fiber, it comes from the sheep, goat, yak and some other animals. Many animals are there, like sheep, goat, yak and other animals are also there, through which we are able to get the fiber that is known as wool. Wool fiber, basically the animals which are living in a mountain areas, hilly areas, that sheep, goat, yak, that from that animals we are able to get the wool fiber. So sheep wool and yak wool, basically that sheep wool and yak wool we obtain in Tibet and Ladakh area. Then Angora wool, that is the wool which we get from the lower side of a goat, that is available in the hilly region. Up under fur of Kashmiri goat, in the Kashmir side, with the help of Kashmiri goats we are able to get that fiber, and with the help of that fiber in Kashmir one shawl is there, that is Pashmini shawl, it is available, which is very soft and silky one. Then fur of camel, alpaca, llama, etc. These are also the animals with the help of which we are able to get the wool. So now here that are the animals we have learned. Now we are going to learn about the sheep, basically with the help of which in India we are able to get the wool fiber, that is sheep. In the sheep also two types of hairs are there, coarse beard hair and the fine soft under hair close to skin, that is of fine quality. Two types of hairs are there, coarse beard hair and the fine soft under hair close to skin. Coarse beard hair means that hairs are very tight and that is not soft one and which we feel very hard. And the second one is the fine soft under hair close to skin, that is of very fine quality, which are used by them, peoples to make the wool fiber. So here is a one process is there, that is selective breeding. The process of selecting parents for obtaining special characters in their offspring, such as soft under hair. As we have learned, the fine soft under hair close to the skin. That means in this process, the peoples are finding such types of parents, sheeps, whose hairs are very soft and which are very under to the skin, which is very soft in touch and feel, so that character should come under their offspring also, so the people may take their offspring and then they are using that fine hair quality for making the wool. That process is known as selective breeding. That means selecting a good quality pair, selecting the parents for obtaining special character in their offspring. That means that fine hair quality they want to find out from the parents and their offsprings. Now we have learned what is wool and what are the types of fiber. Now here we are going to know about the process through which the fiber may convert into the wool, or with the help of that we convert that wool into the fabric. So here is six processes are there: shearing, scoring, shorting, cleaning of burrs, dyeing and rolling into yarn. First one is shearing. Shearing means process of removing the fleece of the sheep along with a thin layer of skin. Shearing means removing the fleece. Basic fleece means hairs. Removing the hair of the sheep with a thin layer of skin. That means when the barbers are cutting the hairs, or when the barbers are making the beards of the boys, then they are losing their hairs with a thin layer of skin also. Like that only, wool is also sheared with the help of that process, and that remove the hair of the sheep with a thin layer of skin. Second one is scoring, removing dirt, grease and dust from the hair removed from the sheep. How much hair we have removed from the sheep, we have to clean it properly. That process is known as scoring. That means removing the dirt particles, dust particles, grass, unwanted things that is present in that sheep wool. Then next one is shorting, process of separating the hair of sheep according to their texture. After removing that dirt particle, dust particle, we have to separate that fiber according to their texture. That means according to their use, according to their quality, we have to separate that fibers into groups. Then cleaning of burrs. Small fluffy fibers called burrs are picked out from the hair and then scored again. Burrs means during the winter time when we are wearing sweater for long days, that means for 2 to 3 days continuously, then small burrs are there, small threads are coming out from that sweater. That is known as burrs. So after shorting that hair of the sheep, then we have to clean that burrs from the hairs, and then again we have to score it. Score definition is there, and that means again we have to remove all the dirt and dust particles from that hair. Then dyeing. The fiber are dyed in different colors. Dyeing means like human beings are dyeing their hairs, not like that. People are also, after removing all the dirt particles and after separating the hair of the sheep, they have to dye according to the color whatever present there. Then rolling of wool. After completing all these five processes, the fibers obtained is straightened. That means the fiber are to be strained straight properly, then combed it, and then again roll it into the yarn, and at the last it comes into the form of fiber, with the help of which we are able to make the fabric.